Hi everyone, welcome back to my page. This week I wanted to discuss what I've learned in my 30s. And I wanted to share that with you guys because it's my birthday today, and what better time to share the wealth than today, as I'm getting older and I look back at how I was in my 20s and how I am now in my 30s, there is a world of difference. And I remember being 28, 29, freaking out about turning 30 and not being where I thought I should be in life. And I had a whole year of anxiety. And because I'm a little bit older, and so are my friends, we all went through this at our own pace in different times. And we all felt the same thing, this fear of turning 30 and not knowing what to do or where we're at. So I just wanted to discuss some things with you guys that were my fears and how unnecessarily worried I was about them. So if you haven't been to my page, welcome. I'm Hamasa. I look at emotional and mental well-being as well as personal development and just day-to-day issues. Please do subscribe to my page so that you're up to date with all my content. So the first thing that I always worried about when I was younger was what people thought of me. I really cared about people's opinions. Obviously, being in the modeling industry for almost 20 years, my life consisted of being in the public eye and being judged on the way I looked. And it was a constant thing over my head. My career and my life depended on it, so I couldn't help but to care. Like, my bread and butter was dependent on that, so I had to kind of give people's opinions the time of the day, which I really didn't feel good about. But when I turned 30 and I realized that it's just people's opinions, firstly, my relationship with my work changed, which I will discuss a little bit later, but also people's opinions and what people think of me really doesn't matter. The only thing that really matters is what I think of me. And the only people that I give time to even share their opinions is my family and people close to me and my friends. So again, that's their opinions. It doesn't really dictate what I can and can't do or how I feel about myself. The second thing would be the emphasis that we hold for our friends and on our friendship groups. When we're older and our friends are also older, everybody has life's responsibilities, families, jobs, and things that take precedent over your hanging out with your mates or your friendship groups. So although I have my friends from my university days and even before that, there is no expectations so much the way it used to be in my 20s. Like, if they don't call me for a week or two and I don't hear from them, I don't get upset or take it personal, because I understand that they have so much going on, and the same way that they understand that I have so much going on. The friendships are still there and solid. It's just that the dynamic's different and things are not taken so personally, things are not held against me and vice versa. And we just have a better understanding. We don't have to see each other all the time. We don't have to call and text each other all the time to make sure that our friendship is still there. We have that reassurance and security that these are my friends and they're not going anywhere. Or that I don't have to constantly go out of my way and kill myself for them to know that I'm a good friend. Like, they know that by now. And if they don't, they don't need to be in my life. So this is my other point. When people end up leaving your life in your 30s, you look at things very differently. You understand that this person had purpose to serve in my life, and they no longer serve that purpose, or I no longer serve that purpose in their life, and they're gonna move on. And if they move on, that's okay, because I'm gonna attract people that are more on my wavelength and that are accepting of my true self and my authentic self. So if your friendships start making you feel the type of way and they no longer have a space or room in your life, that's also okay. Nothing wrong with that. You know, it's part of growth, it's part of moving on. My next point is I'm in a place where I can make my own choices and decisions. I don't run to my parents for everything. I don't so heavily rely on them telling me what to do and telling me the right thing to do. Because it's not that I know everything now, but I'm also not scared of making mistakes, taking risks, failing. Because I know, and I have that confidence in myself, that if I fail, I won't die from it. I'm just gonna learn. and I probably need the lesson. So it's okay if I fail. I'm picking up on something crucial that I didn't know before. And, you know, I speak to my parents. I have the utmost respect for them. I appreciate what they say, and I use them more like a sounding board. I discuss my thoughts and opinions with them, but the indecision lies with me. And so I have trust in myself to be able to do that, whereas I didn't feel like that before in my 20s. And it's also improved the relationship that I have with my parents, because in my 20s, I felt like they constantly told me what to do, and I was rebelling and I was hiding. Whereas now, where I'm more confident in my own ability, I can confidently discuss things with my parents, and I respect their opinions, and they respect mine. They understand that I'm okay, and I'm not irrational, and I'm not childish. So it kind of improved our relationship. I look at them as friends and parents now, whereas before I looked at them as the authoritative figures and my parents. I loved them, but they weren't my friends. They weren't cool for me to talk about things to. But now I don't feel like that. So definitely an improvement there for me. And also, you will choosingly and willingly make time for family. You realize the importance of it. You appreciate them and respect them and see them in a different light. Because when you start thinking of having a family of your own, you appreciate and understand and respect those boundaries. And like I said, when you slowly drift away from your friends a little bit because life happens to you and responsibilities happen to you, that's when you realize that family is also plays an important part, and they're solidly there alongside your friends. Everybody has a role to play, and everybody deserves that time and importance. Next thing is knowing what to do. I thought that in my 30s I'll have it all figured out, but nobody really knows what they're doing. Everybody's kind of winging it. And for me, because I've had a 20-year career in what I was very passionate about, I now have to kind of find my passion all over again. I have to find something else that I'm as just motivated and driven as I was for modeling. And I kind of don't know what that is right now. And I haven't known for a couple of years because I can't seem to be as driven in anything else as I was with modeling. And that's okay. I don't have it figured out right now, but it's not about the destination, it's about the journey. Whereas before, for me, it was all about the destination. It was about the end goal. Didn't matter how I got there. And that's not the right way to be, because you're not present. You're constantly either living ahead of yourself or in the past. And life's all about being in the present moment and taking each day and learning from it. But I only understand this now. So that fast-paced life that I was like living and working and killing myself for my job, I've now realized that I worked this hard to be able to live a certain way. So if I'm killing myself for my job, what's the point? What am I doing it for? Which is my next point, my relationship with my work. Everything that I do now is to feel good, mentally, physically, emotionally, and I'm content with that. That's enough for me. I don't need to be super wealthy or show off what I own or earn. That's not gonna make me happy in the grand scheme of things. My next point to you guys would be to treat your body and mind with respect. Take care of your mental health. I was very neglectful of that, didn't even understand it in my 20s, completely burnt out, overworked, wasn't happy, was letting people treat me a type of way, had no boundaries, had no, you know, understanding of my self-worth. And all of that, it took me 2 years to really sit and analyze and self-reflect and get my mental in a good place, get my emotional well-being in a good place. So I now, in my 30s, understand the importance of your mindset and what it could do for you and how sick it could make you if you neglect it. So don't ever forget your body and your mind. Learning to say no and setting some healthy boundaries is incredibly important. And in order for us to do that and understand what our boundaries are, is we need to get to know ourselves. We need to learn about ourselves. So take that time to get to know your likes and dislikes. You've had all your 20s to throw caution in the wind and do whatever you wanted to do. But now that you've got a world of experiences under your belt about yourself and You've probably experienced heartbreak, betrayal, lies, loss. You know how that goes. So take that and see how you reacted to these situations. Get to know yourself, understand your triggers, understand your weaknesses, understand areas that you need to work on, and set some boundaries based on that. Say no without guilt, and put yourself first. Love yourself, respect yourself, understand your self-value and worth. It's the best thing you could do for yourself. And you can move into your 30s confidently, knowing your capabilities and your weaknesses. Next thing I'd say to you guys is about your relationship status. Being single, being in a relationship, when I was younger, I thought, oh, I'm going to be married by 26, house, kids, dog, cat, car, whatever. I had it all figured out. I thought that's how life goes. I can assure you, life doesn't go to plan. So it's okay and fine for us to change our goals and dreams. It's okay that things don't work out to plan. Like I said, it's more to do with the journey. If you're single, married, in a relationship, it's no one's business. There's no pressure. We don't live in the society that we used to live in. If your goal before was to marry a very handsome man or very rich man, just really think about whether that will keep you happy in the long run. Because what I thought what I wanted as a partner or in a partner in my 20s is very different to what I want or need as a partner now in my 30s. So there's no way that I will settle if I'm not treated right, if I don't feel fulfilled, if I don't feel happy, content, respected in my relationship. And at the same time, I feel no pressure. I find someone that I can be compatible with and spend my life with, have a life partner, great. And if I don't, that's also okay. When and if the time's right, it'll happen for me. But I had this fear in my late 20s that, oh my God, I'm gonna turn 30 and I'm not married. And now that I'm 30, it's great, I don't care. So that's what I mean. Your mindset and perspective changes, and you just have to be willing to let go a little and just trust yourself that you will be okay. My other word of advice for you guys would be to travel is the best teacher for you. I've been lucky to have the opportunity to travel both for my work and personally, but it's taught me so much about myself. If you get a chance to even live and work abroad, please do so, because it tests you like never before. It'll make you grow up more in 2-3 months than you would if you stay in your comfort zone at home in a year. So I would definitely recommend loads of traveling, keep an open mind, and trust that you will be okay. There is nothing scary about turning 30. If you're in your 30s and you're watching this, then you've probably been through similar things to me. So if there's anything that you would love to share about your experiences of turning 30, please do so in the comments below. I'd love to hear how you felt about this and whether that little anxiety set in with you too. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Please do share this with someone that may find it helpful. Like and comment on this video. Please do subscribe to my page, and I will see you guys here again next week. Thank you so much for watching. Mwah.